Welcome back. Prime Minister Malcolm Turnbull says there'll be no change of policy about same-sex marriage, but a couple who've been together for 50 years hope that he will change his mind. Everyone calls them Peter and Bon. Peter de Waal and Peter Bonsall-Boone fell in love in 1966 when gay relationships were illegal and could mean they could even face jail time. Then in 1972, they made history by becoming the first to come out on national TV. Ida Buttrose has their story.
It was the kiss that shocked Australia. This is Sydney in 1972. Peter and Bon came out on the ABC series Checkerboard.
I just felt attracted to him, and my love for him just grew bigger and bigger.
I found that principally I was able to share things with him for a length of time that I hadn't found possible before.
They've just celebrated 50 years together on a day when they'd hoped to marry, but in Australia, that's not possible. Even though they're in their late 70s, they're still agitating for change, here in the same garden and in the same house where they launched their love story. So tell us about that historic moment. Was it brave or foolish?
I think we were naive but very committed to bringing about some change or being part of bringing about change.
There you were, really coming out, which was what this was all about your sexuality.
It was a pretty awful kiss, really. It was more
pretty,
of a
pretty quick,
unfortunately, yes. The couple was terrific, and we wanted to share this, if we could, with other gay men.
But you must have been nervous of public reaction.
Just 10 days after he and Peter appeared on the Checkerboard program, Bon was sacked.
You were working as a church secretary.
Yes.
And you lost your job.
Yep.
You were unemployed.
That's right.
Because of the kiss. So what did you do?
I eventually got a job with the post office. Given a very difficult time, I was asked if I thought I could get along with heterosexual people.
No.
And I said, well, I think my mother and father are fairly heterosexual and we seem to have done all right so far. However, I did get a job with the post office right behind the scenes, sorting boxes of letters out of the public reach.
The Checkerboard show actually resulted in reaching lots of gays who were living closeted lives and had no one to talk to about their lives. And so you started Phone a Friend, which has now become the Gay and Lesbian Counselling Service.
Bon being sacked, he got lots and lots of media coverage. People who were lonely or needed information, gay people that is, used our phone number as well. People at night ring up when they're lonely, they want someone to talk to. Well, that's what we used to get.
And non-judgmental advice.
Yes. Don't you fool now,
welcome now, step back. Take us back to the 60s when you met. What was it like to be a gay man in Australia back in 1966?
We were potential criminals because gay sex in those days, or homosexuality, was a criminal offence if you were caught, even if it was a consenting partner.
You could be jailed for up to 14 years.
Yes, indeed you could. Up until about 1972, we were also potentially mad or insane because the psychiatric guidebook still had homosexuality as an illness.
Gay men were subjected to sort of aversion therapy, weren't
indeed,
they?
Indeed, indeed, yes.
It's hard to imagine now.
It really is, mainly because it was so useless and it destroyed people's lives.
Bon, you were arrested for having sex with another man, weren't you?
Yes.
You had a criminal charge against you.
Charges against me, though, have now been dropped.
Because the laws have changed.
Yes.
But up until then, you could be arrested. And I think you were arrested another time, or
yes,
the police stopped you?
Yes, yes, twice. I spent 58 years as a convicted criminal. Take me to church,
everything, in spite of the prejudice that you found inside your own church, the Anglican Church, you've not lost your faith.
It's my faith, my religion,
your conversation with God?
Yes, yes.
And do you share Bond's faith?
No. I'm agnostic, actually. Very early in our relationship, he came every Sunday and sang in the choir, but that was true love. Of me, not of the church.
Years after the kiss, the first Mardi Gras happened in Sydney and you were there. Now,
we were.
What was that like?
Initially, it was wonderful, liberating. We had a police permit at the end of Oxford Street, the beginning of Hyde Park. That's as far as the permit ended there. But because it was so joyful, so happy, we had gathered strength in numbers, we thought, well, we go on. And of course, once we got to the cross, it was absolute bedlam.
75 demonstrators have been arrested in the latest clash between police and gay liberation protesters in Sydney.
And that's when the arrest and the violence and the riots and the police bashing started. It was extraordinary.
How sad.
Totally unnecessary. It was a peaceful, joyous, wonderful experience up till then.
Just celebrated 50 years of being together and we exchanged rings.
Yes, you did exchange your wedding rings at your 50th celebrations, and it was a very poignant moment because you told everybody that you'd hoped to be married on this day to celebrate your 50 years together.
We're still wearing them on the right hand, which is an old Dutch custom apparently. We're still right-handed.
On your battling cancer, do you think your time is running out?
Oh, yes. I doubt that I will live long enough to see same-sex marriage.
We are still second-class citizens because we don't have those equal rights that heterosexual couples have.
You look as though you're going to be a prime minister when you grow up.
No.
You're doing the right-hand movements.
Story of love.
Yep.
50 years.